I want to talk today a little bit about in-hand work. So to begin with, what is in-hand work? When we talk about in-hand work, we're referring to either working the horse without a rider. So where there's no one on the horse, you're either standing beside the horse, or you can do it with long line standing behind the horse, and working mainly on Piaffe passage and also pirouettes. Or in-hand work can mean where someone is actually on the horse and a second person is either standing behind or to the side of the horse, again helping with the three P's, so Piaffe passage and pirouettes. And then there's three important things to remember. So the first thing is break it down for the horse. The second thing is don't be in a hurry. And the third thing is get help. So the first thing, break it down. You always want to break these complicated movements down in such a way that the horse understands what you're asking. A lot of people make the mistake of just starting to beat the horse on the hind legs and confine it in front, and they run into a lot of problems because the horse has absolutely no idea what they're supposed to do. So breaking it down for the Piaffe, you want to start with leg lifting, which is where you touch the horse on the hind leg with, usually you use a softer whip like a bamboo or the thickened of the whip. You don't want a stinging whip. And just teaching the horse to lift and hold their hind leg up. And then from this, you start taking that forward, teaching them even just at the collected walk that when you touch the hind leg, they lift it a little bit higher, and gradually building up to half steps and from there the other work. So the second thing is don't be in a hurry. You know, training a dressage horse to the Grand Prix takes a long time. It's not something that happens overnight. And it's also not a linear process. Lots of times you go up and down. Some things get better, other things get worse. Some days are amazing and you have an incredible feeling, and then you can't get that feeling back for weeks. So just don't be in a hurry. I do really believe that the in-hand work and the three P's, Piaffe, passage, and pirouettes, are really important for all the horses. In this work, the horses learn to rotate their pelvis under them and bring their back up. And that's really the crux of what we want in these dressage horses. They have to be able to rotate their pelvis under, engage their hindquarters, use their abdominals to bring their backs up in order to do the movements. So kind of even with the young horses, no matter what level they're at, working a little bit the Piaffe passage and the pirouettes is really beneficial to getting them to develop the proper muscles and learn how to use themselves most efficiently in order to do the movements. And then the third thing, getting help. So if you want to make it to the Grand Prix, you have to have help. You have to have eyes on the ground. You have to have mirrors. The reason that this is that sometimes what you feel when you're on the horse isn't what it looks like from the ground. And in competition, the judge sees, you know, from the outside. They're looking in on you. The judge isn't feeling what you're feeling. The judge is only seeing what the horse is actually doing. Especially with the Piaffe passage work, it can be deceiving because when a horse really sits and bends their hind leg joints, they don't bounce a lot, and so sometimes you can't really feel what the hind leg is doing. When it's correct, it actually feels like it's not doing so much. Right now I have a horse that sometimes in the passage he'll double tap on a hind leg. So instead of going left, right, he'll kind of tap his toe and lose the rhythm a little bit, and I cannot feel it. You know, generally I think that I have a good feeling on a horse, but I can't feel it. So I need someone on the ground telling me when it's right and when it's wrong. As far as the in-hand work, you really need someone that is good at it. You can do a lot more harm than good. So you need someone that has good timing with the whip, someone that's not going to overface your horse. That's really important. The Piaffe passage work is really taxing on their muscles. So it's comparable to doing jump squats. You don't want to just do it over and over again until the horse quits you. You want to get the horse to try to do it, you know, just a little bit where they put some effort in and really, really praise them. Otherwise, they're not going to want to do it for you. So, and also the safety aspect of it. You know, I've gotten kicked working a horse in hand. And so you have to stay out of the way of those hind legs. The horses, when they kick you there, it's really fast. You don't even know, you don't even see it coming. And generally, horses aren't out to get you, but you do need to be aware and you do need to stay out of the way because you can get really hurt. So anyways, again, I just want to reiterate that I think the Piaffe passage work and the pirouettes are really important work to do with all the horses. You know, and again, just little bits, starting with the young horses. Of course, you don't expect them to, you know, do 15 Piaffe steps. But just the idea, even just that they rotate their pelvis under and bring their back a little up, all this stuff helps them so that when you get to the Grand Prix or even just moving up the levels, explaining to them how to use their bodies efficiently and correctly to do dressage. So I hope this helps. You know, it's a journey. Don't get discouraged. Just work at it. Play with it a little every day. Don't make it torturous or unpleasant for your horse. Just have fun with it and, you know, get some good help because, you know, you can't do this alone. Even I need help. Even the best trainers and riders in the world, they're not out there doing this alone. So I hope this helps and enjoy your horses, guys. All right.